The Bangalore Broadway Company is a dynamic band of 25 members performing a cappella, Disney music, African folk, Broadway musicals, and so much more. The Bangalore Broadway Company was founded by the powerhouse performer Sowmya Raghavan, a businesswoman and musician who aimed to combine music, dance, and dialogue with this venture. This colorful band has been enthralling their audiences with their striking sounds and unique performances.
Hi there, and welcome to JamToast with me, Vidya Prakash. I am with the Bangalore Broadway Company. There's like 20 of us. Woo!
How did you start Bangalore Broadway Company?
I always wanted to get into the musical space because I grew up with a lot of it. I grew up with a whole lot of Walt Disney. So I started scripting a musical called Sundari. Parallelly, we wanted to develop a group which would add music to the musical. We wanted to develop a group which would add the acting bit and the dance bit. That's how BBC happened. And, you know, it's been great because BBC has sort of taken its own journey and we've grown into a huge band as an independent unit. And we've been performing, and it's been exactly a year. We've been rehearsing for a year. We've just had our launch that happened in May, and we have two more shows coming up. And that's exactly how it happened, and that's how I met all of these beautiful people.
It's difficult to even get like a three-member band, a three-piece band, or a four-piece band. You've got a 20-member band. How did that work out?
25 people, actually.
25, there we go.
Yeah. It's been a whole lot of fun, because what holds the group together, besides music and all of that, is that all of us are friends. I would say this is possibly the largest group of people I know, which has zero politics, which has zero any of that sort of small talk and back talk. And we have so much fun together.
What does Sowmya do when you guys are late?
Well, she asks other people to call us so that she doesn't lose her cool at us. That's what happens.
Those guys who are late don't not answer because it's Sowmya. It's very smart, actually, and it works brilliantly.
Yeah, it does. It works.
First time when I came to Bangalore Broadway Company, I felt this is not my cup of coffee. But then now these people are amazing people. They make you do things. More than these are performers, they are very music lovers. So we enjoy listening to each other. They encourage me and we encourage others.
And I have been a part of multiple bands, but none as big as this one. This is the first time when I'm working with multiple voices at the same time, also with multiple instruments as well.
It's actually real fun and quite challenging in terms of some of the stuff she throws at us. And it's most of the time in another language. and there's a lot of metronome. Yeah. Which never stops, and so that's a very interesting thing for me, and I think it's fun, and yeah, everybody's cool.
It's been an incredible experience for me, because this is the first time I've been in a group where we are doing musicals. These are songs that I would have never imagined learning if not for this group. So for that, I'm really thankful, and it's been incredible.
This has to be the most fun I've ever had with a group of people who love music. And this has to be the most number of people who are supremely talented.
When I met Sowmya, within the first few minutes, I knew she could make this work.
I like to sing backing vocals now and then. And I just thought this was a small project, a small band. We do a couple of shows. I'll come in, sing some backing lines, have some fun, have some popcorn and leave. And then I went for a rehearsal. And then there were multiple languages. There was no popcorn. There was only green tea. Multiple languages. Yeah, there was no popcorn. But no popcorn. But yeah, it's just been an incredible journey in terms of, especially as someone who likes arrangement orchestration, the kind of music that she's introduced us to has just been phenomenal. Every time she brings a new piece, it blows your mind in terms of the music that we're actually working on, and it's improving us on a daily basis musically.
They're just as nutty as you would want a large group to be. And the music has been amazing. It's just all the stuff that I've grown up singing. I've been such a Disney freak as a kid. It was just so much more than that. And we're just a real family. So I'm really happy to be here. Thank you, Sowmya. I love you.
And I really like that whoever we picked comes with their own brand of crazy that just fits in. And rehearsals are just so much fun. I love the variety of music that we do, because it's... it's stuff that we've never been introduced to before, and it's so much fun to break it down to that level and like make sure everyone comes together. And I think my favorite part is when we've been working on a piece for a while, and when you finally hear the harmonies pieced together, it's just so nice. Yeah.
The BBC is my little getaway. So I'm teaching chemistry and logic for 5 days, dealing with Western classical for 3 in class and rehearsals. And then there's Sunday, and then I come here, and it's just fun and madness and such different music. A, it's different from what I hear in most other places, and B, it's just good fun music. You know, it's music after you learn the parts with the metronome, with people saying, okay, this is flat, this is sharp. No, 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 that's not the right sound. This is African, we're not singing in English anymore. Once you get past all of that, it's just fun. It's just good old grooving and moving and enjoying the music, and these looks that we shared in the middle of a song were like, just, oh yeah, you know you're loving it.
I've seen the first vocalist walk in, and then I see so many vocalists now. It's a really nice change.
Hello!
Like, who are all these people?
Welcome to the many people!
So I've never been that exposed to Western music. It was only when I came to college. And all these people, they are so learned and they know so much and they're so sweet. So like, I feel really lucky to be a part of the group.
I was put in a choir when I was hardly like 3 years or something. So when I found, you know, when I discovered this group, it was a breath of fresh air for me, because everybody is communicating, everybody is brainstorming. It's not this, you know, that one person puts in the work and then says, here, go follow this.
This is really something that is really different and so much fun. And after coming here, like, you know, meeting everyone, and it's such a fun group. And I'm really happy to be here.
I haven't sung in a choir in a long time, sang rock music for so long. And then when she said, looking for a bass, I was like, do I qualify as a bass? And then I came in and then I saw Niveda and I was like, I'm so intimidated over here. But then thankfully that they accepted all my flaws and all my notoriousness, as they say. Like I said, I'm damn quiet and shy normally.
So once I started working with these guys, it was really exciting, because there's a lot of things that go in this, and it's really difficult. Honestly, it is difficult. But it was a challenge, and I think that's what makes it nicer.
Love me, kiss me with your breeze, you be my one above.
Sweet as the wind as it gently blows the day away, and the night time comes. Great all the wonders that silence shows. I fall asleep and I dream of the sun and my butterfly.
Of the group, you know, who is the angriest person in the group? Who's the quietest in the group? Who is the drama queen of the group? Right, who is the Hitler in the group? No,
but she has to. She has to. We wouldn't survive.
If she weren't, we wouldn't be where we are.
So it's been awesome talking to you guys. So we're going to have some performances from you. And I just want to know, how do you choose the songs?
I think
every piece that I have picked somewhere takes me back to when I was 6 and 7. I think that's where we end up having so much fun, because it just takes all of us back to being children. The nostalgia, I think it's just that. A lot of these pieces I have collected over the years, because these have been things that I have at some point wanted to do. I didn't know it would be in this amazing format. But I think it's not about anything being complex or like a snarky puppy or anything to do with some like 1 and E, 2E and all of that. But I think it's just things that... It's also there, a lot of it, but I think most of it would take all of us back to when we were children. And what we wanted to produce on stage was something not just uniquely ours, but we wanted to produce something that was sophisticated. So everything, right from the way we presented ourselves, to what we spoke on stage, to how we moved, to how we came in on stage, it was meant to be, I would say, at least going towards a high-end product, which is essential, because it's, I think, a combination of the complexity in the music and vocally, instrumentation-wise, the choreography, the entire concerts are based around storytelling. So we had an MC who was actually, who was saying a story and weaving the music together. So we wanted to make sure that anything that we produce is at least targeted towards being a very good quality product.
Wow, so good to hear this. And you guys are doing absolutely next level stuff. Will's having so much fun and being a crazy family. So thank you so much. And I'm so proud of this group and what you guys are doing. You're fabulous on stage, so I must say that. Love the histrionics, the craziness, and the music is precious. So thank you guys so much for being on JamToast.
Bye.
Bye.
Hear the drums echoing tonight, but she hears only whispers of some quiet conversation. She's coming in 12:30 flight, her moonlit wings reflect the stars that guide me towards salvation. The wild dogs cry out in the night, as they grow restless, longing for some solitary company. I know that I must do what's right, sure as Kilimanjaro rises like Olympus against the Serengeti. I seek to cure what's deep inside, frightened of this thing that I've become. Gonna take a lot to drag me away from you. There's nothing that a hurried man or more could ever do. I bless the rains down in Africa. Gonna take some time to do the things we never had. Hurry, boy, it's waiting there for you. Gonna take a lot to drag me away from you. There's nothing that a hundred men or more could ever do. I bless the rains down in Africa. I bless the rains down in Africa. Oh, I bless the rains down in Africa. Oh, I bless the rains down in Africa. Oh, I bless the rains down in Africa. out in Africa. We're gonna take some time to do the things we never had.